topic is area of a sector. What's a sector? The portion of the circular region enclosed by two radii and the corresponding arc is called a sector of the circle. So a circle is given. Just the center we are marking as O. Now two radii, just we are selecting one radius OA and another radius OB. Now you can see this portion, inside this portion is called sector. Here you can see the area, the portion enclosed by OA, OB, the two radii and the corresponding arc. This portion, it is a sector OA, and just you are giving a point here, name P, OAPB. OAPB is a sector, which is a minor sector. So what is a minor sector? Minor arc, you know, if the arc is having length smaller than a semicircle, then it is a minor arc. So what is a minor sector? The region enclosed by a minor arc and two corresponding radii. This portion is minor sector. Then the other portion is what? It is major sector. Okay. So here it is minor sector and major sector. Now suppose the angle, here it is the two radii making an angle at the center, that is theta degree. Theta means just a variable, just as x, y, z, etc. Just you are giving a measure, theta degree. Okay, so here it is the angle AOB given as theta degree. Now we are going to find the area of this sector OAPB. How we can find it? Just you can see one circle is there. What's the area of the circle? Area of the circle is pi r square, that you have already studied. And can you say the angle around the center? Here it is at O. What is the angle around it? You can say that it is 360 degree. So corresponding to the central angle 360 degree, we are having the total area of the circle, that is pi r square. Okay. If the angle at the center is 360 degree, then the area is pi r square. And now we are having the angle, we are selecting a portion of the circle which is making an angle theta degree at the center. Okay. So just we are selecting, if we are selecting 1 degree, if it is 360 degree, the area of the portion is pi r square. If it is 1 degree, what is the area of this portion? Here we can say that it is pi r square by 360. Okay. If the angle is 1 degree, it is pi r square by 360. The same way, if the angle is theta degree, can you say the area of the portion? It is pi r square by 360 into theta. Okay. Pi r square by 360 into theta, which we can write as theta by 360 into pi r square. Okay. So here it is the formula for finding the area of the sector which is making an angle theta degree at the center, and also r. R is the radius of the circle. Okay. So here it is the formula, theta by 360 into pi r square. Theta is a central angle. So, theta out of 360, theta by 360 into pi r square. Area of the full circle is pi r square. We are selecting a part only, which is making an angle theta degree at the center. Okay. So, theta by 360 into pi r square. Semicircular region. What's a semicircular region? The portion covered by half of the circle. Okay. So here it is, this portion. A circle is given with a center O, and also a diameter is given. If a diameter is given, this portion, okay, here it is the semicircular region. What is the area of this portion, can you say? The total area of the circle is pi r square. So what's the area of the semicircular region? It is half of the area of the circle, that is half pi r square. Actually, it is by the same formula. What is the formula you have studied? Theta by 360 into pi r square. Can you say the angle made by the semicircle at the center? What's the angle here? It is 180 degree. At the center it is making, the diameter is making 180 degree. Therefore, here the angle is 180. 180 by 360 into pi r square. Now you can see that it is half. That is why the formula you are getting half pi r square. So area of the semicircular region is half pi r square. The same way, can you say the area of a quadrant? What's a quadrant? If the circle is dividing into four equal parts, then it is called a quadrant. It is called a quadrant, 1/4 of a circle. So a circle is given and you can see that you are dividing that into four equal parts. And this portion is called quadrant of a circle. Okay. So just we are dividing the whole circle into four equal parts. This portion is quadrant. So it is 1/4 of a circle. Now can you say the area of the quadrant? It is 1 by 4 pi r square. That also by the same formula. How we can say that it is? Here can you say the angle? If the whole 360 degree you are dividing into 4 parts. So each angle is what? 90 degree. So you are getting that 90 by 360 into pi r square. 90 by 360 means what? It is same as 1 by 4. That is why you are using this formula 1 by 4 pi r square. Understand? So area of the semicircular region is half pi r square. And also half of the circle it is half pi r square. Here it is 1/4 of a circle which is 1 by 4 pi r square. That is area of a quadrant is 1 by 4 pi r square. Okay. Now can you say the perimeter of a semicircular region? Perimeter of a semicircular region means here the diameter, that is 2r. Radius plus radius 2r plus the arc length. Okay. So perimeter equal to 2r plus arc length. What is the length of the arc? Here you can just write L. What is the length of the arc? It is half of the length of the circle. So total length of the circle is what? It's a circumference 2 pi r. So half of that means 2 pi r, half of 2 pi r, it is pi r. So 2r plus pi r. See that? What is the perimeter of the semicircular region? Here it is the diameter plus the length of the r, that is 2r plus l. And the arc length we can say that it is pi r because total length is 2 pi r. So half is pi r. So 2r plus pi r. If you are taking r as a common factor, r into 2 plus pi. Or otherwise directly also you can use 2r plus pi r. And the same way, can you say the perimeter of the quadrant? Perimeter of the quadrant means here it is, here also 2 radii. Okay, so it is 2r plus. What is the length of the arc here? It is 1/4 of the total length of the circle. So 2 pi r into 1 by 4. 1 by 4 of 2 pi r. Understand? So it is pi r by 2. 2 pi r by 4 means pi r by 2. So your quadrant is here and its perimeter is 2r plus length of the arc. This length of the arc is pi r by 2. It is 2 pi r by 4. Understand? So it's the perimeter of the quadrant. Perimeter of the semicircular region is pi r plus 2r plus pi r and here it is 2r plus pi r by 2. Okay. Length of arc. Length of arc of a circle. A circle is given. Here the center is O. And now you can see that this point is A. And here it is another radius B. So OA, OB, 2 radii. And this arc length. Length of the arc here it is arc AB. The minor arc and also arc AB. Here it is the major arc. Suppose this point is P, then APB is minor arc. And if it is Q, AQB is major arc. How we can find the length of this arc? Length of this arc means here it is OA and OB making an angle theta degree at the center. Corresponding to this theta degree, can you say the length of this arc? So you know that total length of the circle, that's a circumference. Here it is 2 pi r, the formula you have studied. Total length of the circle is 2 pi r. Corresponding to that, the central angle is what? 360 degree. So if 360 degree angle is there, then the length of the arc is 2 pi r. Now, can you say if theta degree at the center, what's the length of this arc? It is theta by 360 into 2 pi r. See that formula? Theta by 360 into 2 pi r. Just you remember the formula of area of the sector, theta by 360 into pi r square. Theta by 360 into area of the circle. For area, theta by 360 into 2 pi r for finding the length of the arc, because the total length of the circle is 2 pi r. Length of the circle means circumference of the circle, which is 2 pi r. So you can remember this formula, that is length of the arc is theta by 360 into 2 pi r, where r is the radius of the circle and theta degree, here the 2 radii making an angle at the center, here it is theta degree. Corresponding to this, length of the arc is theta by 360 into 2 pi r. If you need to find the length of the major arc, how we can find? So this angle we need to consider. Okay, so this angle how we can calculate? It is 360 minus theta degree. Because total angle is 360, this angle is a larger angle, which is 360 minus theta degree. So corresponding to that, we can find 360 minus theta by 360 into 2 pi r by using the same formula. Okay, can you understand this length of the arc? Next, area of a segment. Area of a segment. You know what the segment is. What's the segment? That's a region covered by arc and the corresponding chord. Suppose a circle is given here with the center O. Consider the chord AB. And this region covered by the chord and the corresponding arc. Suppose the point P here, APB, it's a minor arc. So, region covered by this arc APB and the chord AB. It is a segment. So, other portion also a segment. The remaining portion of the circle also a segment. Now, if corresponding to this minor arc, we can say that it is minor segment. Minor segment. And also we can say that it is having an area smaller than a semicircular region. And what about the remaining portion? It is more than the area of a semicircular region. And also the arc here, it is, suppose the point Q here, then AQB. This arc is major arc. Corresponding to this major arc and the corresponding chord AB, we can say this portion, this area is major segment. Major segment. Now we are going to find the area of this segment. How we can find it? Just to join this OA and OB. Now you know what is this shape here, it is OAPB. What is OAPB? It is a sector. So here from this sector, the total area OAPB, it is a sector, and from this area we need to avoid the area of the triangle. Understand? This portion we need to avoid, then we are getting the area of the segment. So for finding area of the segment, we need to find the area of the sector minus area of the triangle. Understand? For finding the area of the segment OAPB, how we can do that? Area of the sector minus area of the triangle. Area of sector OAPB minus area of triangle OAB. Okay, that is the area of what? Segment. And here also we can say area of segment, we are selecting a minor segment only. And how we can find the area of the major segment? Here segment only, if we are using the word segment, it means minor segment only. The same way sector also, if we are using the word sector, it means minor sector only. And how we can find the area of the major segment? Area of major segment, how we can find it? Can you say the method? Here you can see that if you know the area of the minor segment, area of the circle minus this minor segment gives the area of the major segment. Understand that idea? We can apply here. So area of the major segment equal to what? Area of circle, area of the whole circle minus area of minor segment. Area of minor segment. So we are calculating the area of the minor segment first, then area of the circle minus area of the minor segment, that will give you area of the major segment. Okay, understand? Now can you write the formula for finding the area of the minor segment and major segment? Area of segment. Area of segment, you know that area of the sector minus area of the triangle. Area of the sector means what? Here we can write. Area of the sector means, remember, theta by 360 into pi r square. It is the area of the sector minus area of triangle. What's the formula you can use? Half BH. Usually we are applying this formula, half BH, base and height. If you know the base and height, we can find the area of the triangle like this.